योगायञ्जस्व नैवं पापमवाप्स्यसि तस्मादुच्यस्व भारत. Battling. As you know, our own life journey, it will be like battling. So we battle for every aspect from dawn to dusk. In the so-called urban life, every day, every minute is considered to be battling. Very morning you start battling for milk, battling for air, battling for food, battling for schooling. So battling. Mother also battling, father also battling, children also battling. Yuddham. But how to conduct this yuddham? This is very natural. We cannot escape. Na dainyam na palayanam. So from starting our own childhood, we started battling now. Our small innocent children also battling for their school bus, everywhere they battling. Then how to conduct that battling? That is what very well structured in this Samarasya. You know, for example, if just you want to eat a jackfruit is very well liked by many people. But eating jackfruit is not so easy, because its skin is so hard. Even though it is so ripe, you have to take very sharp knife to cut it. There also is very danger. You may cut your finger. And after having broken it again, when you start to eat those fruits, every fruit is covered by some aspect, some chemical thing which is so hard. It just rubs your hand and covers your hand and you cannot eat it. And just making it beside all those unwanted things, you have to pick up every fruit of the fruit and eat. If you know that art of removing and art of eating, then only you can eat junk fruit. Otherwise, it will be very difficult. Big battling. That is why experts say, before you go to eat jackfruit and break it and eat it, just you rub your hand with coconut oil. So if you rub your hand with coconut oil and start eating, you can simply enjoy that ecstasy of eating jackfruit. That is an art, you know, eating that fruit. Likewise, living our life, battling our life problems, also it is like that. If we have that oil rubbed to our hand, like that, if we have that oil into our mind, then easily we can attend all our life problems, battling, and win. Ultimately, we will be the winners. Battling. Krishna used that oil for battling. Even all those who drive different vehicles, they also know. Now and then they give for service their car, their motorcycle. Without oiling, timely oiling, proper oiling, you cannot drive your vehicles. So that oiling is very, very important. This oiling, how to do? That is very well portrayed in this Samarasya Shloka Sandha. This is a Samarasya. That means harmony at your intellectual level, harmony at mental level, harmony at psychic level, harmony at the intellectual level, pranic level, vital level, body level, total harmony. It is the real panacea for conducting our life journey smoothly. So oiling. That oiling, Krishna says, it is called Buddhi Yoga. This Buddhi Yoga word repeated thrice in the whole Bhagavad Gita. Buddhi Yoga Upasitya Machitta Satatam Bhava. And in the 10th chapter, he gives this particular insight about Buddhi Yoga. Actually, the whole summary essence of all four streams, Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Raja Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Krishna gives this particular name, Buddhi Yoga. In the 10th chapter, it is there, Sloka number 10. Sloka number 10. Tesham Sarvata Yuktam Bhajatam Priti Purvakam Dadami Buddhi Yogam Tam Yenamam Upayanti Te. This is the text. Sloka number 10, chapter number 10. Satata Yuktanam, that word is important. Firmly attached to Bhagavan. Unshakably concentrated on that divine form. Total commitment to devotion. Bhajatam Priti Purvakam. Priti, art of loving. That is very, very important. If you have that art of loving, it is not art of living, art of loving. Priti Kala. That Bhagavan mentions here. That Priti Kala makes one totally integrated with Buddhi Yoga. For practice of Buddhi Yoga, Priti Bhava is very, very important. You cannot have that type of negative rejectionist attitude. Now in this so-called modern world, we are troubled by this negativity. Everywhere you go for rejection, fault finding. No. Rasadrishti means finding good things. That is called samarasya. Samarasya means finding good qualities in your friend circle. Now we must have that positive attitude, power of positive thinking, that is what psychologists say. Many great psychologists of modern time also tell about this art of loving. Eric Fromm, a great psychologist of modern time, wrote a book called Art of Loving. Wherever there is an art of loving, there will be sane society. That is what he says. Sane and insane, two words are there in English. Sane society means swastha samaja. So samarasya is very, very important, which makes individual practicing art of loving. Consequently, whole society will be full of positivity. People will be having reciprocal exchange of love and affection, so that there will be sharing and caring. That is called samarasya at the societal level. And people always find good things around. Oh, my students, my children, my masters, my teachers, my neighbors, my colleagues. Everywhere you find good things in them. If we are fault finders, everywhere we see some hole, some defect, and every time we blame others, whatever success comes, I'm the reason why. Success. Because of me, because of me. Failure comes, someone is branded. Because that fella, it failed, this failure happened. That's what we go on blaming. No, no. It is very, very bad style of practice of management. No. Always find good things among your co-workers. Your co-workers will be happy. In Sanskrit we say, Priyavakya Pradhanena Sarvetushyati Jantaha. If you just share good words, all will be happy. Normally, all younger people, they expect some good sweet words from the elders. But some elders, they habituate this type of negativity. Always they highlight, exaggerate, faults of younger generation, go on blaming them. No. No, no. So that what you expect from others, that we must do. So that fault finding is not. Only we have to find good things, positivity. That is called samarasya. Samarasya, master keyword is preeti. Bhajatam, preeti purvakam. Krishna told this preeti word in Bhagavad Gita is repeated many times. So that what? You can easily battle for your life. When you share good words with your co-workers, whenever you will be in trouble, they come and extend their helping hand. That is what our rishis were there like that. So that this samarasya means this type of positivity, power of positive thinking. This is called buddhi yoga. Buddhi yoga upashriti. Machitta satatam bhava. So this buddhi yoga or preeti or samarasya, all they stand for power of positive thinking. That power of positive thinking is the strength of every yogi. You have no right to find fault with others. We have to find good things among all. Thinking this, simple formula, power of positive thinking, power of positive thinking, it is called buddhi yoga, it is called preeti bhava, it is called samasya. That is what we have to practice for battling. Then Yudhyasva Bharata, it is not with the arrows and bows we battle with love, we battle with the power of loving.